Before being put to death, it's customary to allow criminals, even the worst of the worst, to say some final few words. Sometimes inmates use these words to say goodbye to their families, or make peace and apologies. Other times, they make the most terrifying statements you can think of, ones that would haunt the world for decades and decades to come. From death promises to morbid ramblings, here are the top 10 scary last words from prison inmates. Number 10. George Bernard Harris. Starting off our video relatively tame, and by tame we mean a promise of murder, first up we have George Bernard Harris's infamous last words before he was executed by lethal injection on September 12th of 2000. Harris's crimes date back to 1989. He'd won $500 on a craps game, and then he used the money to get two machine guns. On March 11th, he gave the guns to a second man to hold on to, and when he came back, he discovered that the man had given the guns to a third man and lost them. Harris's response? He shot the man with a revolver. His famous last words, "Somebody needs to kill my trial attorney." Number 9. George Engel. Hooray for anarchy. This is the happiest moment of my life. It's some pretty chilling last words to speak before you're hanged to death. But those are the last two sentences anarchist George Engel spoke. He was the type of guy who didn't like rules and was heavily involved in activism and protests in Chicago. Engel was convicted with conspiracy for planning a protest bombing that took the lives of 7 police officers, 4 children, and injured tons of other people. Number 8. Eileen Woronos. This one will keep you up at night. Next up is the terrifying promise Eileen Woronos made before she died. Before ending up in prison, Eileen had suffered a terrible life filled with abuse. Her father was a child molester who committed suicide in jail by hanging himself, and her mother abandoned her and left her to be raised by her grandparents. By the age of 12, Eileen was heavily involved in drugs. Her life decision would later lead her to become a prostitute. She would later go on a killing spree that warranted an entire movie based on her life. For those who are curious, it's called Monster, and she was played by Charlize Theron. Eileen's murderous rampage occurred in 1989. She killed 7 men that picked her up on a highway, and although she claimed she killed them out of self-defense, the sentence was to death by lethal injection. On October 9th, 2002, her dying words were, "I'd just like to say I'm sailing with the Rock, and I'll be back like Independence Day with Jesus on June 6th. Like the movie, the mothership of all, I'll be back." Number 7. Tom Blackjack Ketchum. Before Tom Blackjack Ketchum's incapacitated body landed on his feet and remained standing for some time, Tom Blackjack Ketchum gleefully said, "I'll be in hell before you start breakfast, boys. Let her rip." Ketchum was an outlaw cowboy who killed someone in 1895. Following that murder, he and his gang hid out in New Mexico, where they went on a robbery spree. Ketchum was captured during an unsuccessful attempt to rob a train. Faster than you could blink, he was arrested, tried, found guilty, and sentenced to death by hanging. He was the first person in New Mexico to be hanged for a train robbery, so his execution date was a pretty big public spectacle. Number 6. Robert Alton Harris. "You can keep a king or a street sweeper, but everyone dances with the Grim Reaper," are the haunting last words by murderer Robert Alton Harris. If you consider how monstrously violent the crime that landed him in prison was, the words sound even scarier. In 1978, Harris and his brother hijacked a car that had 2 teenage boys inside. They demanded that the boys drive them to a remote location where the Harris brothers brutally and violently murdered them. The Harris brothers then took the teenagers' car and used it as a getaway car after robbing a bank in San Diego. 1 hour after the crime, they were arrested for murder, kidnapping, auto theft, burglary, and bank robbery. One of the officers that arrested them was actually the father of one of the murdered teenage boys. Robert Harris was put to death on April 21st, 1922 in San Quentin's gas chamber. Number 5. Torre Twanay McNabb. At number 5 are the hateful words Torre Twanay McNabb spewed at the world, influenced by large amounts of cocaine. McNabb was on the run from a bail bondsman when he got involved in an accident. When a police officer pulled up to respond, McNabb panicked and descended upon his patrol car, firing at least 4 times at the officer in a senseless, needless crime. Although McNabb's lawyers tried to get the sentence to be anything but a death sentence, which they called cruel and unusual, the lethal injection took place in 1997. His last words were, "Mom, sis, look at my eyes. I got no tears. I am unafraid. To the state of Alabama, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you." And leading up to his execution, he gave the world the middle finger, twice, with both hands. Number 4. James Jackson. Then we have the spiteful prison wife of child killer James Jackson, said before he was executed by lethal injection on February 7, 2007. Before he committed his atrocious crime, James Jackson was apparently struggling with drug use, holding down a job and threats of divorce from his wife. And one day, he snapped. He killed his wife and his two stepdaughters. Moments before he was killed, he said, "See you on the other side. Warden, murder me. I'm ready to roll. Time to get this party started." Number 3. David Long. Before rambling about monsters and reformatory schools and penitentiaries, David Long led a life packed with suffering and trouble. Born in Texas but mostly raised in California by an abusive alcoholic father, Long spent many years addicted to dangerous drugs. His mother died when he was 10 years old, triggering further troubling behavior. He was in and out of foster homes and at the age of 12 was admitted to a California reformatory. In 1986, following an argument, he killed three women, and following his arrest, he confessed to several horrifying crimes, including murdering and beating a gas station attendant to death in 1978. He also admitted that he'd killed a former boss of his in a 1983 fire, and while on death row for his other murders, he revealed he'd set another fire in 1986 that's responsible for the deaths of two women. 2 days before his scheduled execution, Long overdosed on prescription drugs and had to be hospitalized and put on a ventilator. However, Texas officials refused to delay the execution, and the death sentence took place as scheduled. When asked if he would like to speak a few final words, Long said, "I can't really pinpoint where it started, what happened, but really believe that's just the bottom line. What happened to me was in California. I was in their reformatory schools and penitentiary, but they create monsters in there." Number 2. Jeffrey Dahmer. Ever wondered what the last two words cannibal, sex offender, and serial killer Jeffrey Dahmer spoke? This is one inmate in our video who wasn't executed. No, he was brutally beaten to death by one of his fellow inmates because of, and this is according to the inmate, he was a sick and creepy man in prison. He used to make it so his food looked like human body parts and drown them in ketchup to make it look like blood. You can imagine why they wanted him gone. Now, if you don't know who Jeffrey Dahmer is, he's only one of the most dangerous and terrifying serial killers of all time. His unheard-of, cruel murders involve necrophilia, cannibalism, and permanent preservation of his victims' body parts. He was sentenced to the murder and dismemberment of 17 men and boys in the Milwaukee area. According to the inmate who killed him, a murderer called Christopher Scarver, Dahmer's last words were, "I don't care if I live or die. Go ahead and kill me." Number 1. Peter Curtin. We saved the most chilling last words for last. Good luck falling asleep after this. And number 1 is Peter Curtin, also known as the Vampire of Dusseldorf. Somehow, Peter Curtin takes the trophy for being the most deranged killer on our list, even topping Jeffrey Dahmer's awful crimes. See, Peter earned the name Vampire because he often drank the blood from his victims' wounds while they were still alive. His crimes include killing a 9-year-old girl and 9 other people, but these are only things we know for sure. There's no telling how many poor souls were lost to this monster. Once arrested, he was promptly sentenced to death by beheading. Before his head was chopped off, he left the world with words that would haunt it for centuries. "Tell me, after my head has been chopped off, will I hear at least for a moment the sound of my own blood gushing from the stump of my head? That would be a pleasure to end all pleasures." And that's all of the scary last words we have for you today. Do you have chills yet? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you know any famous last words, if you enjoy this video, hit that like button. And before you go, if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to Weeklypedia and click that notification bell to be alerted whenever we upload a new video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.